the Mile High City, Denver, Colorado. And we have a good one for you today. It's fourth-seeded Washington State out of the Pac-10 against fifth-seeded Notre Dame from the Big East Conference, coming to you from the East region. The winner of this game will take on the winner of North Carolina, Arkansas next week in Charlotte. So let's take a look at our starting lineups, and we'll start on the left, the Fighting Irish of Notre Dame. Heron Godey there, big guy in the middle. He is Mr. Double-Double, a bruiser. Meanwhile, for Washington State, Derek Lowe can really shoot it. Weaver is a slasher and do-it-all kind of player, and Baines is coming off one of his best games as a member of the Cougars. Mike Bray celebrating his 49th birthday today, the head coach at Notre Dame, his team coming in with a 25-7 record. On the other sideline, Tony Bennett, his team 25-8. It's Washington State, Notre Dame, Gus Johnson, Len Elmore with you. And Lenny, as this one gets ready to begin, your officials, Mark Whitehead, Mr. Ted Valentine, and Mr. John Hughes, what should we pay attention to early on?
Well, we have two teams with different strengths. Notre Dame, an outstanding up-tempo perimeter scoring team with a dominant big man in the middle. Notre Dame led the nation in assists with 19, and Washington State outstanding defense, third in the nation in points allowed, 57 per game. And you take a look, Notre Dame three-point barrage, we talked about them leading the Big East in three-point field goal percentage as well as 3 points made. And busy Baines, Aaron Baines, perfect from the field against Winthrop, 9 for 9. He's got to keep Luke Heron Godey busy.
So Luke Heron Godey and Baines, that should be a matchup that we'll pay special attention to. Heron Godey, 6'7", 251, a sophomore. Baines, also a big fella, 6'10", 270. He's an Australian-born player who also played rugby over there, so he is used to contact, and they say he's got a little mean streak in him as well.
Well, Washington State, terrific at controlling tempo, and they've got a demonstrated value for possessions. 10 turnovers a game, third fewest in the nation.
Notre Dame closed out the 2007-2008 regular season by winning 11 of its final 13 games. And the tip controlled by the Cougars. Here comes Taylor Rochesti with 10 assists in their opening round win over Winthrop.
You take a look at Notre Dame right there. They are playing man-to-man, but they will certainly switch and help with a cross of the ball or any kind of exchange.
Hillsland with the rebound, brings it into the front court to Jackson. Now McElarney, he has in the gym range, folks. As soon as he crosses the midcourt line, he is ready to shoot it. Most of these Notre Dame players can really stroke the basketball from deep, except for Jackson, their point guard. And he fires a three. Uh-oh. Uh-oh.
Well, having seen Torrey Jackson many times in the past and covering the Big East, I recognize that he shows up for big games, and he will be able to knock them down from beyond the arc with regularity as well, given the light.
Coming into this tournament, Jackson, a 28% three-point shooter, 17-59. Now Baines backing up. Jump hook on the baseline, way off the mark. Heron Godey with the rebound.
Aaron Baines can't move Luke Heron Godey as easily as he did the big men for Winthrop.
And jump ball is the call. The possession arrow favors the Irish. Last year, Notre Dame losing in the first round to Winthrop, 74-64. They defeated George Mason. Baseline jump shot, McElarney, no. Jackson with the rebound.
Jackson, a terrific rebound to four guard, had 8 rebounds against George Mason in the first round game.
There's a teardrop, batted around, Heron Godey, another rebound. And a new shot clock.
Give Jackson credit for keeping that one alive as well.
Notre Dame coming off a 68-50 win over George Mason in the first round. It was easy from the very beginning. McElarney turns the corner and draws a bump. And that'll go against, looks like Baines trying to hedge on that pick and roll.
And we've seen that throughout this tournament. Big men stepping out on the high screen and roll, trying to hedge, force the guards to flatten out. But it appears that many of the big guys are staying a little bit too long, making contact, and the officials calling it tight.
McElarney averages 15 a game down the lane. The teardrop is good.
Well, that's a shot you'll see from Kyle McElarney when he gets into the paint, drives to the basket. He's not one to try to finger roll it. He'll throw it with his palms up.
McElarney, a junior from Staten Island, New York. So here come the Cougars. Rochesti drives baseline, cut off. Washington State coming off a 71-40 win over Winthrop. Baseline, Rochesti, and he knocks down a three.
Excellent penetration and kick, and then the extra pass by Calgill to Rauchewski. Washington State, a team that likes to play with each other. They recognize their strengths and weaknesses. Not going to wow you with their quickness, but their ball handling and teamwork.
McElarney deep. Batted around. Baines clears it. Here comes Lowe.
And boy, I never thought I'd be able to see this, but next to Aaron Baines, Luke Herangode looks almost normal for his size.
And there's Baines again from Rauchewski. Rauchewski and Baines really were thinking with the same brain in their first round matchup.
Well, that's what you want to do, to stay on the same psychic level as your point guard if you're a big man. And look at the double team on Herangode, making him give it up.
They swing it, Hillsland. Almost traveled, spins, off the window, no. Baines with another rebound, his second.
And again, we talk about tempo control. Right now, tempo is in favor of Washington State. Game tied, but look at Rauchewski walk the ball up in no hurry whatsoever.
Washington State started the season winning 14 straight games. Low in and out. It was their best start since their 1916-1917 national championship team, as the Irish throw the ball out of bounds, and the second half against Winthrop turned out to be a clinic for Washington State.
Well, it certainly was, and again, Winthrop, to their credit, tried. They had some open shots, couldn't knock them down, but Washington State took advantage of every mistake. They pushed the ball up. They went to their big guy, which was their main advantage, and Aaron Baines did not disappoint. 9 for 9 from the field.
19 points also. Baines coming up with 8 rebounds.
And that's really what Washington State needs to do now. You look at them, very patterned, very methodic right here on offense.
Baines again, forcing his way inside, got it up, slipped out of his hands.
Well, even though he didn't make that one, Aaron Baines is key for Washington State because he keeps Luke Herangode busy. And if you get Herangode busy, maybe get him in foul trouble, Notre Dame is a much different team.
And Herangode with 3 rebounds. Here he is on the baseline. The Big East Player of the Year, 15-footer McElarney. You can't give him any daylight on that jump shot.
That's right. I've said it time and time again. You can't let him out of the bottle. You got to know where he is. A little token three-quarter pressure, zone pressure from Notre Dame. And I'm not sure why they're doing that. If they expect to slow Washington State down, they don't have to worry about it. Washington State wants to walk it up.
Now Weaver baseline low, quick release. Long rebound picked up by Baines. And a new shot clock for the Cougars, who finished 3rd in the Pac-10, 11-7 overall. Low again, and hits off the bounce that time. So Derek Lowe from Honolulu, Hawaii. And here's a young man that accepted his scholarship without even seeing the campus. He knew he wanted to play in the Pac-10. Inside, Herangode bump.
See, Herangode can't move Aaron Baines. He dips that shoulder. Baines is not retreating.
Backdoor stolen by Lowe. He brings it up. Penetrates, gets to the bucket, and a blocking foul coming up on McElarney.
Well, you called it, Gus. You got him retreating. You get a defender on his heels, you got him pretty much where you want him.
And welcome back to Denver. Our game tied at 7 apiece. Washington State out of the Pac-10. Notre Dame out of the Big East. A 4 versus a 5 here in the East region. Gus Johnson, Len Elmore. And here comes Derek Lowe. What an interesting kid, as we mentioned prior to going to commercial. Lowe accepted his scholarship without even seeing the campus. He was recruited by Coach Bennett when he was assistant to his dad, Dick Bennett. His third team, all Pac-10.
And again, a young man who, not necessarily the point guard, but a guy who rarely turns it over. Only 38 turnovers during the regular season. 6 fewest by any players who've played 1,000 or more minutes. 12th in the conference in scoring. So not only does he put it in a basket, he doesn't give it away.
Averages 14 points per game. 9-7. Washington State and a steal. Weaver. Second team all Pac-10. Weaver down the lane. Wraps it around. Step back. Jump shot low. Pure.
That's good teamwork right there. Derek Lowe recognizing he was getting too far under the basket on the break. As you mentioned, step back. Weaver recognized it while avoiding the charge.
Now Jackson guarded by Lowe. McElarney curling. Picked up by Jackson on the baseline. Penetrate. And a reaching foul coming up. So let's take a look at our mini bracket, as we call it. The winner of this game to take on the winner of North Carolina, Arkansas next week in Charlotte.
And believe me, that's not going to be a cakewalk for North Carolina. Arkansas is doing a terrific job, led by Sonny Weems against Indiana yesterday. And, you know, that wasn't really a surprise. Indiana kind of still confused as to their coaching situation and such. Just didn't come out with the same fire you would expect. And Arkansas demonstrated they belong in this tournament.
John Pelfrey, their coach, learning from Billy Donovan and his coach, Rick Pitino. Pelfrey was an assistant to Donovan at Florida and played for Pitino at Kentucky. 11-7. Cougars. Here's Rochesti from Santa Barbara, California. He's a herky-jerky player that can knock down a shot and get his teammates involved. Low, penetrating. Caleb Forrest has checked in. He knocked down two or three jump shots on the baseline the other day. And a foul.
And you're right, you look at this Washington State team, and except for Kyle Weaver, not a lot of blazing speed out there, not a lot of high leapers, but they beat you with guile, with savvy. They'll change speeds on you. You call it herky-jerky, I'll call it change of speed. But either way, they will get defenders off balance. They move the ball. They play with each other terrifically. Notre Dame, on the other hand, improved defense. Just giving up about 70 points a game. A lot of that is because of the pace in which they play.
Forrest finds Lowe. He takes a three. And Aaron Godey goes up high for the rebound. That's his fifth. So now Aaron Godey has Cowgill checking him. He's stronger than Cowgill. Let's see if Notre Dame recognizes. Airs off the bench. And that one out of bounds.
You called it right there. Should have had an opportunity to go into the big fella. Posting up the long but very lean Robbie Cowgill, who's a terrific defender in his own right, though. All-conference defensive player. But again, down on that low block, I'm just not so sure that he can handle Luke Heron going on a consistent basis.
So Weaver brings the ball up the floor, and that's the thing about Kyle Weaver. He is so versatile.
Yeah, you talk about Kyle Weaver's versatility. Top 20 in scoring, rebounds, steals, and assists in the Pac-10.
Cowgill dumps it down. Forrest tracks it down. Weaver penetrates, and the finger roll goes. And Notre Dame wants a timeout. Washington State on an 8-0 run. 13-7, Cougars with the lead.
Well, that timeout definitely was because of the fact that Kyle Weaver able to go right into the heart of the Notre Dame defense, and Mike Gray can't allow that.
13-7, Washington State with the lead over Notre Dame, a 4-5 matchup. The winner to advance to the Sweet 16. And here come the Irish of Notre Dame. McElarney had 15 points in their first round win over George Mason. Rochesti guarding. They look inside. Here's Aaron Godey. Backs up on Cowgill. Draws a double. Finds Ayers on the weak side. Now Jackson poked away from behind. Picked up. Aaron Godey inside. Double clutch. No. Jackson Wheeler. 10 to shoot. Shot clock didn't reset. McElarney, he'll take that. And a rebound to Weaver.
And that was terrific defense by Washington State. Knocked the ball loose. Even though Notre Dame got it back, the defense recovered and wound up getting McElarney taking a shot on the 6'10 Cowgill outside. And Cowgill on the other end answers.
Cowgill, a senior, knocks that one down. He's from Austin, Texas. And Washington State takes a 15-7 lead, currently on a 10-0 run.
Well, they've been able to do it again with strong man-to-man defense, communication, help with Cowgill trying to guard Aaron Godey. Aaron Godey's forced to step way outside, not in a territory in which he's comfortable. And once again, Washington State with the rebound. It's not only the defense and it's the helping, but on the other end, playing at their tempo. Right now, this is Washington State's kind of ball game.
Now Weaver, along with Rochesti, he slips, keeps his dribble alive.
This is exactly what Washington State wants to do. On the reset, they got it in Kyle Weaver's hands.
Step back 20-footer. Long rebound picked up by Ayers.
Kind of would have expected him to put it on the floor and create something.
McElarney along with Jackson, Ayers, Aaron Godey, and Kurz.
Again, look at the defense sticking. When Aaron Godey gets it inside, they're covering up with the double team and allowing Notre Dame just one shot
only that, they're doing a terrific job of guarding the perimeter and not allowing this Notre Dame team to get off those uncontested three-point shots.
Well, Notre Dame may have to space a little bit wider right now because such good help from Washington State and their ability to recover. You've got to spread them further and make that recovery a step longer.
Weaver to the bucket. Kyle Weaver gives Washington State a 17-7 lead. Cougars on a 12-0 run. And here come the Irish. They've missed their last six.
Rochester doing a nice job not allowing, look at the step out, not allowing McLaurin to go around the corner.
Jackson crosses over on the hop. Hands it off, Aaron Godey, nicely done as Jackson figured out a way to get his big man the ball.
But man, they had to work awfully hard to get that bucket. And that's what Washington State will do to you. They will make you work hard, use time on the clock. Remember, Notre Dame averages about 81 points a game. They don't take that much time on the clock to get their shots. They're able to get into their stuff and get good shots quickly, but this Washington State defense has made them work.
Rochester. Baseline, Weaver, he does have range. He can hit a 20-footer, kicks it, Rochester rises. And Aaron Godey with his sixth rebound. 17-9, Notre Dame, 4-14 from the field. That's 29%. Now they're gonna post. Inside, Kerr's jump hook, way short.
That time. Nice job by Forrest just to hold his position. Forrest Kerr's to fade away on the hook shot. And once again, Washington State walking it up, taking their time, allowing the cutters to get set using the screens.
Weaver, one-hand pass, and it's out of bounds. Last touch by Notre Dame. 8:34 to play in the first half. Washington State with a 17-9 lead. .34 to play in the first half. Washington State with a 17-9 lead. Cougars with the basketball. And so far, Washington State off to a great start. 7 of 15 from the field. That's 47% shooting. Notre Dame, different story. They're at 26% shooting. Baines just checked back in. His jump hook off the mark. And here come the Irish. .17-9, Washington State. With the lead, a 4 versus a 5. Washington State out of the Pac-10, Notre Dame out of the Big East. And so far, Lenny, the Cougars defensively have come up with a good plan to slow down the Fighting Irish.
Well, they certainly have been able to control tempo on the offensive end. Defensively, double-teaming Luke Carangotti down low. You know, remember, this is an outstanding defense. Third in the nation in points allowed at 57, really slowing down the Notre Dame attack with just basic fundamental man-to-man help recover and get a hand in the face to challenge the shooter.
Hillsland feeds Aaron Godey. They swing it. Zeller straight away. Way short. Notre Dame starts this game 4 of 16 from the field. 25% shooting, 1 of 5 from downtown.
Remember, Notre Dame averages 81 points a game. Right now with only 9 on the board, you can tell Washington State controlling this tempo, playing the game that they want to play.
Forrest, wide open. Nice pass from Derek Lowe, and the Cougars take a 19-9 lead. Hillsland inside.
And again, the double, the help, the screen, and then the recovery.
Peoples just checked in. He gets to the basket, and it's called for an offensive foul. 7:22 to play first half. .713 to play in the first half. Washington State up 19-9. Washington State, 7:05 to play first half. And so far, this Cougar team from the Pac-10 Conference, they've had all the answers regarding the Fighting Irish of Notre Dame.
Well, they certainly have. Defensively, they've been able to cover shooters, you know, double team Aaron Godey down low, recover. And on the offensive end, it's all been about tempo, to run it their way. Very deliberate, getting their cutters open, being able to share the ball. Notre Dame really not having an answer for it.
Long rebound picked up by Herren Godey. He hasn't been scoring the ball as well. Only 2 points. He averages 21, but his rebounding numbers are great at 7 already, as Jackson misses that one driving to the basket.
Well, Herren Godey can't get anything because Washington State's so quick with the double team. They're double teaming with other front court guys. And when he gives the ball up, backcourt perimeter guys able to recover so quickly and contest shots.
Harmelin can't get it to stay down. Here's Lowe with the offensive rebound. Kick to Rochesti, the lefty. And Hillsland calls it in.
Washington State getting shots right now. They're going into a bit of a mini slump.
Hers, Herren Godey off the front rim and in. So now that's the adjustment for the big fella. He's stepping out, and maybe he'll get a little bit more success or find some success from the perimeter.
Well, after that shot, he may want to step out a little more, but that's not normally his game.
Can he hit it?
Luke Herren Godey has hit them in the past, no question about it. But he's only 3 for 8 from beyond the arc, and that kind of mid-range, no more than about 15 feet.
Another rebound for Herren Godey, his 8th. 19-11.
He's so much more effective down low on the blocks, but that kind of shot will certainly loosen up the defense.
Baines guarding him. Now McElarney, nice pass on the baseline to Herren Godey. He can't get it to fall, gets his own rebound and draws contact.
Well, we call him the bull in the china shop as he tries to get the crowd into it. There's a sea of green behind us, but he is relentless. That's one of the things that separates Luke Herren Godey from a lot of big men in the country. The fact that he doesn't care what he looks like, he keeps going after it, going after it. A coach's dream, a guy that never gives up.
And Baines picks up his 2nd foul for Washington State as he looks over at the bench to see if he'll be coming out of the game.
And that's a key situation for Washington State. With Baines picking up his first, he went to the bench, and Robbie Calgill, number 34, 6'10", but not as bulky. And you take a look at the matchup right there. The goal for Washington State was to keep giving Baines the ball, to keep Herren Godey busy on one end. Certainly on the other end, the double team. Herren Godey now starting to find a little bit of his range and a little bit more opportunity to put the ball in the basket.
So Baines goes to the bench with his 2nd foul. He's coming off a 19.8 rebound game in the first round against Winthrop. 9 of 9 from the field. Notre Dame starting to find its rhythm. Here's Lowe. Chesty popping. He finds Forrest. That's his shot. Not that time. Weaver with the rebound and stick back.
And see, Kyle Weaver is the one guy Notre Dame doesn't seem to have an answer for. You know, he's been involved in an awful lot of the offense. And just when they need a bucket, whether creating for himself or someone else.
Weaver with 6 points and 4 rebounds. Herren Godey, jump hook. Kerr's offensive rebound and foul.
Again, you look at Kyle Weaver on your left-hand side of your screen. He comes in, no one blocks him out. And there he is once again. And he's playing in the backcourt, so it's up to the guards to really make him accounted for. And they started dropping back instead of blocking out.
So the first free throw good for Kerrs as McElarney checks in, replaces Jackson. That's the thing about McElarney and Jackson, they both can move from the 1 to the 2 spot. Gives him some great versatility.
Particularly McElarney, who came to Notre Dame as a point guard, a scoring point guard albeit, but definitely a point guard with point guard instincts when he needs it. And he's a tremendous shooter, so he certainly can stretch the defenses and then create for guys as you spread the D.
Kyle Gill forced it up and goes down. 23-15. Kyle Gill with 4 points. McElarney guarded by Rochesti. Hillsland.
You see the recovery right there after the double team. Defenders get back to the shooters.
Knocked away, stolen by Weaver. What a play. Now that explains to you Kyle Weaver's game.
Well, he's long, he's quick, he's athletic. And among Pac-10 players, he's the first guy in the history of the Pac-10 to have 1,000 points, 500 rebounds, 400 assists, 150 steals, and 75 blocks.
That's right.
Is there anything else you can do?
No, there is nothing else you can do. And have a million-dollar smile.
The man is a player. No question.
Beloit, Wisconsin, 6'6", 201. 23-15, Cougars. Now low. He's got a quick trigger. And Forrest can't hold on. We'll head the other way.
That was a careless pass by Derek Lowe, and he knew it and took responsibility. Got to snap those passes, particularly against this Notre Dame defense, which, again, despite allowing 70 points a game, is a pretty good defense. Notre Dame fourth in field goal percentage D and sixth in three-point D in the Big East.
First turnover for Washington State. Notre Dame has turned it over five times. Now Heron Godey posting Kalka. McElarney driving. Ah, nice play. Couldn't finish. Out of bounds, and we'll stay right here. 3:44 to play. First half. Washington State with a 23-15 lead over Notre Dame. 3:44 to play in the first half. Washington State on top, 23-15. A four versus a five. The winner to advance to the Sweet 16 to take on the winner of North Carolina and Arkansas in Charlotte next week. ...23-15, Washington State, 3:30 to play in the first half.
And again, we've seen a tremendous display of defense from Washington State. Notre Dame at this point, 5 of 22 from the field, including 1 of 5 from beyond the arc.
Baseline, Forrest.
And what it's been about is Washington State being able to double Heron Godey, being able to recover for shooters and be fairly efficient on the offensive end, although they are 10 for 25, not exactly lighting it up themselves.
Heron Godey calling for it inside. McElarney. And they almost throw it away. Jackson saved it. Great play.
Just barely, foot almost came down before that ball was released.
Heron Godey had it blocked.
Seems like everywhere Luke Heron Godey goes, you see a white shirt. He's now 2 of 8 from the field. And again, tremendous help defense from Washington State. But it's not just the help. It's when Notre Dame gets beyond the double team and they kick it out, Washington State still able to recover and challenge shooters.
Weaver, guarded by Ayers. Forrest steps back and rattles it home. He loves to roam that baseline on either side. And Caleb Forrest now has 4 points. 25-15 Cougars.
And Kyle Weaver knows it too. What a luxury to have a guy like Kyle Weaver able to break down the defense when your offense is stalled.
Knocked away, stolen low. He's got Forrest on the wing. Here comes low to the bucket and five. And Derek Lowe will go to the line and shoot two.
We're talking about Washington State being a tempo control team, not if they have the opportunity to push it. Derek Lowe, maybe known as a jump shooter, but a pretty tough young man.
Up in Pullman, they say he plays like Steve Nash. He can get guys involved, he can penetrate, hit deep jump shots.
That time he took the bang from Rob Kurz.
So Derek Lowe from Honolulu, he is of Polynesian and Japanese descent. Second free throw good, 27-15, raised by his dad. Washington State with its largest lead of the game.
And again, you got Notre Dame walking the ball up, an 81 point per game team. Doesn't want to walk it up, they want to push it, but that Washington State defense has dictated tempo.
Kurz deep. Batted around. Look at Jackson in there with the rebound. Smallest guy on the floor, and he'll stick it back in.
Well, Torrey Jackson averages 5 rebounds a game. Had 13 rebounds earlier this year against Pittsburgh. And again, a guy at 5'10", always willing to stick his nose in and battle among the trees.
Jackson, sophomore from Saginaw, Michigan, went to Buena Vista High School. They produce a number of very good Division I basketball players over the years, but Weaver could have been one of them as he strokes at 8 points now for Weaver, and the Cougars take a 29-17 lead.
And Kyle Weaver at 6'5", playing against the shorter Notre Dame backcourt, able to get his shot anytime he wants. Plus, with that handle, he can knife through the defenses.
And Kurz fouled on the floor with 50.3 seconds remaining. So what's the adjustment if you're Notre Dame that you make based on what Washington State is doing defensively?
Well, the one thing you want to be able to do is spread them a little bit further and continue to move the ball. You got to explore inside out. Right now, Harren Goede getting frustrated, stepping out to the perimeter trying to handle it because there's not a lot of opportunity down low. But you got to be able to take the double team, turn and face and hit the open man, and then from there rotate. Torrey Jackson shouldn't be the guy taking that shot in this kind of need situation.
29-17. As Washington State brings it into the front court, Weaver, another sign of his versatility. He can handle the ball in space, run the point, get the offense going.
And now they've switched. Zach Hillsland on him. Hillsland at 6'9 provides more of an obstacle for Weaver to shoot over, because Weaver was having his way against the shorter guards, McElarney and Torrey Jackson.
So here comes Rochesti, their point guard, into the front court, 10 to shoot for the Cougars. Rochesti starts on the wing, 6 to shoot. Here's Lowe, 4 to shoot, with the screen, fires anyway.
Oh, man.
8 seconds to go, Ayers in the corner. Kurz leans in, got it to fall. And he wanted a foul, won't get it. And that's the end of the first half. Washington State shoots 46%. Their defense holds Notre Dame to 7 of 28% shooting, 25%. And the Cougars lead at 32-19 at the break.
And you tell me Derek Lowe was low down on that one, taking two of the big fellas. But Notre Dame pushing the ball up the floor like they want to. And then a nice job by Kurz not to give up on it.
...32-19, Washington State leading at halftime. And here is the in-game box score powered by CBS College Sports Network, the 24-hour college sports channel from CBS Sports.
Well, again, Luke Harren Goede really got a net thrown on him so far by Washington State D.
Cougars with the basketball, 4 versus 5, the winner to advance to Charlotte to take on the winner of North Carolina and Arkansas. What should we expect to see as this second half begins? Baines, blocked from behind, gets it back, and he'll go to the line.
Well, again, it comes down to keeping Luke Harren Goede busy. A good job by Washington State in the first half, double teaming, getting the ball out of his hands. And now you make him play defense. They go right away to Aaron Baines.
So Aaron Baines in the first half, 2.6 rebounds. And that one rimming off. The first half comparison for Notre Dame tonight and their first half against George Mason.
Well, again, let's say it, and all due respect to George Mason, this is a much different team, particularly on the defensive end. The most impressive aspect of the first half was the outstanding defense by Washington State, double teaming down low, then able to get back and recover to thwart the shooters from perimeter.
McElarney. Woo! That's a 3-and-1.
And right away, Notre Dame tries to rectify the problems they had in the first half. Just a little handoff to Kyle McElarney. It wasn't going inside out. Allows McElarney to get behind the slight screen set by Torrey Jackson. And that's what Notre Dame needs. This is a team that led the Big East in three-point field goal percentage as well as three-point makes, about 8 per game. And now they're 3 of 11 from beyond the arc.
So here comes Rochesti. He draws McElarney. Weaver, along with Kyle Gill, low, quick fire, off a screen, in and out. Loose ball, McElarney with the board. Here come the Irish baseline. Harren Goede, back to McElarney. They run the pick and roll.
And look for Notre Dame to try to spread the floor a little bit more to force the help to try to come a step later.
32-22, Washington State is led by as many as 15. Rochesti to Baines, and that's an offensive foul as he just laid in to Luke Harren Goede.
Smart play by Harren Goede, again, recognizing that Baines, big and brawny, didn't have a whole lot of control on that drive. And you see him use that left arm. And that's the third foul on Aaron Baines. He's the one guy for Washington State in foul trouble. Caleb Forrest with 2, everybody else with 1 or none.
That ball batted out, picked up by Rochesti. He's got low on the wing. And he'll back it up and decide to run a play.
And no one for Notre Dame in foul trouble.
Rochesti left-handed. Rebounded, Kyle Gill. And a new shot clock for the Cougars.
And you see Kyle Weaver say, fellas, why are we rushing? Slow down. That's their game. They control tempo in the first half by using their half court with precise execution.
Weaver
cut off on the baseline. 18 to shoot.
Got a mismatch here. Heron Godier on the perimeter with Weaver. And McElhoney trying to guard Cowgill down low.
Here's Weaver, shows it, and banks it in. That's a tough shot. He has 10 points now. Kyle Weaver, 5 of 8 from the field. Heron Godier.
Again, spread the floor if you're Notre Dame. So when the help comes, you got an ability to at least be able to kick it out and force that help to come slower. But Jackson on the drive just can't knock it down. As you see him surrounded once again by 2 to 3 white shirts.
So Weaver will walk it into the front court with Lowe. Lowe with the step on the baseline, a little cutting Baines, and a whistle and a foul on the floor in the paint. It will go against the Irish.
And again, one-on-one, Weaver against Heron Godier, a mismatch, gets him up in the air. And then with outstanding body control, watch him make the fake and then he squares his body up. When you can face your numbers at the basket, your shoulders are square, you've got an opportunity to make the shot even though you're off balance.
So McElhoney picks up his second foul. He remains in the game guarding Rocheski. Weaver attacking, gets there easy.
Tell you what, Kyle Weaver, X factor. No one on this Notre Dame team seems to be able to guard him on the perimeter. You put a bigger guy on him, he goes around him. Put a smaller guy on him, he shoots over him.
Weaver now with 12 points on 6 of 9 shooting. Also 5 rebounds, 2 dimes. 17:02 to play in the second half. Washington State with a 36-22 lead. Now Jackson, the inbounder to McElhoney. He puts it on the floor, gets to the basket, tough shot. Couldn't get his shoulder square on Rocheski.
And Taylor Rocheski again, good position defense without fouling. Just got to marvel at the fundamental soundness of the Washington State defenders, both in man-to-man as well as team defense.
Lowe stepping out. And Torrey Jackson will push it. Ayers quick fire. He's got to hit one. And a whistle and foul offensive coming up against Kurz. Notre Dame just frustrated, folks. Irish are shooting 8 of 33 from the field, 24%. The Big Brother house is crazier than ever. See what all the buzz is about. Tomorrow, Tuesday, and Wednesday only on CBS. 36-22, Cougars. And here's that slowdown pace once again. Taylor Rocheski, their point guard. Kyle Weaver came all the way from Wisconsin to play with the Cougars. Kyle Gill, a Texan, and he lays it up and in.
And once again, Washington State recognizing the double team, waiting until they commit themselves and then finding the open man.
Timeout Notre Dame. Washington State with the 38-22 lead, largest of the game.
They're not allowing Notre Dame to get around them at any point in time and really doing a terrific job. And our fundamental soundness comes from Dick Bennett on the left, the dad of Tony Bennett, Washington State coach on the right. Dick Bennett taught the game the way it's supposed to be taught. It's all about the fundamentals carried on by his son Tony here, particularly on the defensive end.
And we had an opportunity to talk to Coach Bennett before the game. He sat down with us as McElhoney hits a running jump shot. And one thing that I noticed that he said when we spoke with him, Lenny, was how nervous and how much anxiety he would have win or lose day to day as a coach in college basketball.
Well, once a coach, always a coach, even in retirement.
He told us that he couldn't even watch the first round game for Washington State against Winthrop. He was back in Wisconsin because he just gets too nervous.
And even more importantly, once a dad, always a dad, watching his son do his thing as a coach in these Washington State Cougars.
Lowe off the dribble, baseline, Cowgill. 5 to shoot. Cowgill 4 to shoot. Lets it go and no. Rebounded by Heron Godier. So if you're Notre Dame, what do you have to do, Len? Uh-oh, right now they get to the basket and a foul. Hillsland at the free throw line. As Forrest picks up his third foul. Now I asked you a question before the break. What does Notre Dame have to do to get back in this game?
Well, first of all, they've got to be able to rebound and continue to rebound as Heron Godier did. Limit Washington State to one and out, and then you've got to kick the ball out, look for fast break opportunities. Notre Dame is an up-tempo team and they need to run, but also have the discipline that if they don't have numbers to flow into their secondary break, and that's when they can start finding their three-point shooters.
Rochester in low in the backcourt with Weaver, Harmeling, and Cowgill.
Of course, a couple of defensive stops here without even a shot by Washington State would help.
Washington State is led by as many as 16. Rochester in and out. Loose ball, and that one is... Oh, a foul coming up against Cowgill as he goes over the back.
Sure, even just to get your team in the mood to run, I'm not so sure I agree with walking the ball up if you're Notre Dame. I mean, you got an opportunity now to continue to push, get the defenders back on their heels.
Inside, Heron Cody, and he'll be fouled from behind. Now, when we saw Notre Dame in the first round against Mason, and you've seen them all year, they like to get it off the boards, get it up the floor. They'll take the first available shot no matter where it is on the court. But so far, Washington State has been able to dictate the pace of the game.
Yeah, but right now it's starting to come apart a little bit for Washington State, particularly from a rebounding standpoint, as Notre Dame is gaining more and more confidence. But still, if I'm Notre Dame, I want to push the ball up. If not, just trot it up, just to get the defenders to continue to back up. And then you run your stuff, even if you don't have a fast break. But on the defensive end, rebounding, pushing the ball up the floor, and looking for guys to be able to step up and hit threes off of penetration or just your secondary break. And you look at Notre Dame right now, full court pressure, trying to speed this game up.
Now they put Jackson on Rochester. Here's Weaver on the baseline. He's been the equalizer, off the mark, batted out. Here comes McElarney.
Now you got to push. If you know the name, push. There you go.
Jackson, reverse layup, no. Heron Cody with the offensive rebound. Can he hold on? Yes, he can. McElarney straight away. Got it. And here come the Irish.
Now, if you're Washington State at halftime, I'm Tony Bennett. I tell my guys, you know they're going to make a run. You know they're too good not to make a run.
Notre Dame on a 9-0 run, 13:49 to go. Here come the Irish. Notre Dame currently on a 9-0 run. Washington State is led by as many as 16.
And you see Washington State not very comfortable with the pressure, and that's why Kyle Weaver's the guy who's got a better chance of bringing it up and avoiding the pressure. But you saw what happens when Notre Dame pushes it. They have an opportunity to get the defense on their heels. All five guys were back for Washington State, and still they got a chance for a layup, an open opportunity in the paint for an offensive rebound.
Here's Rochester. Notre Dame trying to make Washington State play faster. Baines, 10 to shoot, inside, jump hook. No. Rebounded by Heron Cody. Here come the Irish. Ayers tracks it down. McElarney.
And he's liable to pull up right there. Not shy.
Heron Cody, 15-footer.
Now that was a little bit too quick right now. I'd like to see Luke Heron Cody back down on the block. Aaron Bain a little frustrated. Baines is frustrated on the offensive end. And when you catch a guy frustrated on the offensive end, he's thinking about it when you get back on defense. Take a shot at him.
Now Lowe steps back in the corner and rattles it home. Derek Lowe is the equalizer, folks. Between Lowe and Weaver, when Washington State needs big baskets, they usually go to those two men. 40-31. Lowe now with 13. Hillsland wheeling inside. Hangs in the air. No. Heron Cody with the rebound. No contact. No foul, rather. Looked like there was contact.
You know, sometimes you're a victim of your size, and maybe there's a subconscious expectation, a guy like Luke Heron Cody, you see DeJuan Blair from Pittsburgh and others, that they can take the contact. And you take a look at McElarney and Heron Cody, they've picked it up. First half, particularly McElarney, a little dormant. Second half, he is starting to establish himself.
So Jackson and Heron Cody head out of the game. Peoples comes in, as well as Kurz. Jackson picked up his third foul at the 12:14 mark here in the second half. Weaver the inbounder.
Again, those substitutions by Mike Gray is just to give those guys a breather, knowing that he's going to need them down the stretch.
Inside, knocked away. Great job by Ayers, getting a hand in the passing lane. McElarney fires off the break.
I told you, he's liable to pull up from anywhere. Just gets the defender backpedaling, all of a sudden he raises up. That time he missed it, but Kyle McElarney, there are times when he'll knock them down with great regularity.
Lowe with the step, gets straight to the bucket. Derek Lowe is a serious ball player, 15 points now.
And talk about being calm, collected, and under control. Derrick Lowe just sized up his defender and went left on him. Shows you how good he is equally with both hands.
Inside Kerrs, nice catch. And he'll get it to go from McElhinney.
And you knew Jackson and Aaron Godey weren't going to stay out long. They're back at the scorer's table ready to come in.
Kerrs averages 13 a game. He has six tonight. Rochesti, he's got that ball on the string. He is a terrific setup guy for this Washington State team. Lowe pops out, thinking about it. Crosses over. Weaver, and a foul. 10:55 to play, second half. Back to Denver right after this. All right, a look at the summary by half.
Well, again, you take a look at the second half. Notre Dame shooting a little bit better, but two threes, four or five from the free throw line have helped them close this gap. And Washington State's come down a little bit off of having a pretty good shooting first half. Not really able to hit anything from beyond the arc.
So Baines is on the bench right now for Washington State. He has three fouls. Cougars with the basketball. Rochesti, Lowe, Forrest, Cowgill, and Weaver. Here's Lowe. Driving, stops, 15-footer, short. Aaron Godey with his 17th rebound, folks. That's a career high. As you take a look, the winner of this game advances to Charlotte to take on Carolina or Arkansas. And a foul on the baseline coming up against the Cougars.
Well, again, Notre Dame much more assertive right now. We talked about four or five from the free throw line in this half.
And that is the fourth foul on Caleb Forrest. He checks out. Baines comes back in. Now he has three. McElhinney. That's an air ball rebounded by Weaver.
Didn't have his legs underneath him. Probably took that shot a little too quickly.
Goes for Cowgill.
Again, much more deliberate offensive trip that time for Washington State, getting back to what got them the lead.
And a foul coming up on Lowe. Cowgill with 8 points, but it's been the Weaver and Lowe show.
Absolutely, and Kyle Weaver taking advantage of the bigger guys using his quickness. Derrick Lowe just finding the range. Both of those guys obviously are go-to guys for Washington State.
And that's the second foul called on Lowe. Jackson at the line. And the first one good. Tomorrow on 60 Minutes, a little stone box is said to have a big connection to Jesus. Tomorrow on 60 Minutes. Torrey Jackson on the season. Not a very good free throw shooter. At a little over 50%.
But you know what? He usually makes them down the stretch when it counts. Right here gets another opportunity. Lane violation by Washington State.
Notre Dame as a team, 9 of 10 from the stripe this evening, but their percentage from the field different. 11 of 42, 26%, as Jackson gets the second, and we have a 9-point game. Here come the Cougars, 19 of 43 from the field, 44%. Rochesti, guarded by McElhinney. Lowe, he can score points in bunches. Drives. Weaver. Cowgill, and hits it again.
Pretty basketball. Once again, ball movement, movement without it. Penetrate, kick. Just take what the defense gives you and execute.
Cowgill with 10, a turnover. Weaver ahead of the field. And he is fouled, and they'll call it an intentional. So Weaver will have two shots, and Washington State will get the ball.
Well, terrific job defensively, just digging down and grabbing it. Rochesti, and then he kicks it out front. Now watch McElhinney grabs around the waist of Kyle Weaver, and that's why the intentional foul call was made. There was no play on the ball.
Yeah.
touched every part of the rim.
Every part of the rim there. The shooter's roll. The hit new comedy, The Big Bang Theory, is back at all new Monday at 8, 7 Central on CBS. So McElarney picked up his third foul, 48-35. Washington State with the ball as well. Cowgill has been very important. He's been able to step out and hit 15-foot jump shots off penetration. Here's Weaver, and a touch foul coming up.
We take a look at the Pac-10 teams in the tournament, and the Pac-10, a lot of people label them the strongest conference in America. Obviously, the last three, USC, Oregon, and Arizona, are gone. Oregon and Arizona, a lot of question about whether they even belong in the tournament right now. And, you know, the naysayers have an argument right at this point.
As Weaver hits the first free throw, Washington State with a 49-35 lead. And look at the numbers for Kyle Weaver, 15-8. Great defense as well. He also has three assists. 49-35. Here's McElarney and Jackson.
And Notre Dame has to get good spacing because of the double teaming down low.
Ball knocked away. Weaver. Wow, what a player, folks. Weaver in the open court. Almost lost it. Baines tracks it in. 8:48 to play in the second half.
And once again, Washington State goes back to their sets. Not in a hurry.
Rochesti. Lowe's fires. And hits. Three-point field goal for Derek Lowe. Washington State smacking around Notre Dame. Timeout Irish. 8:27 to play, second half. Cougars with a 52-35 lead.
It's a simple game. You take a look right here of Derek Lowe. He's just going to come down. Screen is going to be set, a high screen. He comes off it, and Notre Dame having all sorts of trouble with that. And watch Cargill set a high screen. Jackson can't get over. The help comes too late. And they've been doing that simple play just about all evening. And Notre Dame hasn't really gotten wind of how to solve it.
Washington State is on an 8-0 run to take its largest lead of the game. McElarney, Kurz, Aaron Godey can't hold on, out of bounds. And don't forget, the winner of this game will take on the winner of North Carolina and Arkansas next week.
That was Notre Dame's nice turnover. They averaged 13 per game, but this is a critical point right now where possessions for Notre Dame are so important. They need to get some shots up.
Washington State so patient, low inside, Baines up and in. 4 points for Baines. Low with another good assist. Now Heron Godey double teamed, and he fires up a bad shot.
It was a fourth. Rob Kerr's wide open in the corner. Heron Godey needs to receive, step back and take the double team facing the court, and then find the open man.
Knocked away, stolen by Heron Godey, and he'll bring the ball up the floor. Luke Heron Godey is 2 for 12.
Once again, he forces it.
And this time he gets his own rebound and banks it in. And a timeout on the floor, 7:17 to play. Second half, Washington State with the big lead. 54-37. Washington State on top, 7:17 to play here in the second half.
Go right now, baby. Right now, let's go, Washington. Come on, baby. Let's go.
Maybe the leprechaun is giving some instructions on how to take that double team.
That's right.
And get the ball swung, because Luke Heron Godey doesn't necessarily have to force. There's an open man when he gets double teamed. They just got to be able to locate him. And then once that ball swings around, he can now track to the ball and get a better shot.
Approaching the 7-minute mark of the second half. Washington State taking their time. Rochesti, Cowkill. This time, he picks it up. 8 to shoot. Rochesti, shake and bake, fires. That's a brick. Aaron Godey with another rebound, his 19th.
He carried it.
And yes, he did. Welcome back, 54-37, Washington State leading Notre Dame with 6:38 to play in the second half. It's Johnson, Len Elmore with you. Here's Taylor Rochesty. It's been all Washington State. Derek Lowe has 18 points. Kyle Weaver with 15.
Washington State, nice job of weathering a Notre Dame run at the beginning of the second half to build this lead back out.
Aaron Godey with his 20th rebound.
But you have the feeling, again, the explosive offense of Notre Dame, they've got one more run in them. I'm sure Washington State well aware of that.
Loose ball, Weaver cuffs it, and he will bring it up.
But a sign of the frustration, Notre Dame, Luke Herangode stepping outside shooting threes, which is not his forte.
Kyle Weaver, though, 9 rebounds to go along with his 15 points and 3 assists. And we'll take an even closer look at what the Cougars, rather, have done this evening.
Well, you take a look at Lowe and Weaver, and they've carried their team offensively. McElarney and Herangode have been in it, although, again, aside from the 20 rebounds by Luke Herangode, usually the only guy on the board, and a lot because Washington State retreats. Notre Dame really not playing its game, not able to push the ball up the floor, not able to get the three-point shooters open enough to their liking.
Ball rejected by Weaver.
He's everywhere.
Wow, what a basketball player, folks. Kyle Weaver.
Again, it bears repeating, the only guy in Pac-10 history to have 1,000 points, 500 rebounds, 400 assists, 150 steals, and 75 blocks.
And Lowe throws it out of bounds. Only the 5th turnover tonight for Washington State.
And Weaver comes from the weak side in a flash and uses his length for the rejection. Just a terrific basketball player. Defies categorization.
15 points, 9 rebounds, 3 assists, and a block. McElarney chased, deflected by Rochesty, curves, and ripped down by Baines.
Well, I think Baines, the victim of a terrific acting job by Herangode. Look at Baines right there. Herangode reaching for it, and Baines uses that left arm. It's definitely not enough to throw a guy the size of Luke Herangode on the ground, but when you're down as much as Notre Dame is, as late in this game, you try everything you can.
That's the
WWE wrestling?
Yeah,
one of those.
Bit. That's right. That's the 4th foul on Baines. Here's Herangode inside the runner. No, loose ball rebounded by Baines again.
And I bet
his 10th.
Baines keeps those hands to his side now.
Under 5 to go as Washington State walks it up. You just have to appreciate the way the guards have played for Washington State today. Weaver, Lowe, but even how Rochesty has handled things when he has it in the front court.
That's right, game management. And when the shot clock runs down as it is now, around 7, Rochesty, you don't see any panic. They just go into their stuff. They know who to get it to.
Lowe deep in the corner. Calgill with the rebound and put back. Washington State looks like they are headed to Charlotte. 56-37.
And that was just plain old hustle, Robbie Calgill. And that particular play, he wanted it more than the Notre Dame rebounders.
4:03 to play in the second half. Notre Dame still puzzled, trying to figure out a way to figure this Washington State team out. Ayers. And Ayers has come up with nothing this evening.
Every jump shot, for the most part, by the Irish has been contested. Washington State, again, able to double-team the post, make it difficult for Herangode, yet still be able to recover the shooters and get a hand in the face, so there are no uncontested threes. And the Irish thrive on three-point shots, averaging a little more than 8 per game.
And they've taken a bunch of them. They just haven't been able to knock them down.
Ayers, no points, 0 for 4 from the field. Notre Dame, 3 of 16 from the three-point line. Weaver, baseline. Aaron Godey with his 21st rebound. He brings it all the way up and has it stripped by Lowe.
Can't do it by yourself and his teammates. Nobody calling for the ball. At this point in time, a lack of leadership on the floor. You can't let your big guy, who is not a great ball handler, try to go coast to coast. Somebody's got to save big fella. Give it up.
56-37, back after this.
Take a look at Dick Bennett, dad of Tony, a moment ago. Got to be awfully proud of the way his son's team has played, particularly on the defensive end. But you talk about Marquette Stanford, that's the third head-to-head Big East Pac-10 matchup in this tournament. West Virginia dispatched Arizona back on Thursday. Obviously, Washington State having its way with Notre Dame. That game, Stanford-Marquette could be the rubber match in the matchup of two pretty good conferences.
Now Weaver backing his man down, draws a double, finds Calgill. It's knocked out of his hands, but they say last touch by Washington State. ...56-37, Washington State with the lead, 2 minutes and 43 seconds remaining in this game. McElarney. And right off the bench, that's Zeller. His shot off the heel, rebounded by Rochesti. Tonight, Chevrolet players of the game are Luke Aaron Godey. Shot a low percentage, 3 of 16, but did have 22 rebounds. And Kyle Weaver, 15 points, 9 rebounds, 3 assists on 6 of 11 shooting. He also had a block shot.
Weaver was just everywhere, especially when Washington State needed him the most.
And Baines with the rebound. So the Big East versus the Pac-10. Let's talk about it.
Well, in the three head-to-head matches, obviously Arizona dispatched by West Virginia. Marquette Stanford finishing up right around the same time this game is. And it looks like the Big East, at least with the one-point lead by Marquette, that's the one that's going to make a difference. This game may be about over.
2:29 to go, 20-point lead for the Cougars.
And I say maybe because, again, Notre Dame's still an explosive offensive team. Still have the option of the three-point shot, the great neutralizer, equalizer, whatever you want to call it. But he gets you back fast.
You better hurry. Aaron Godey. Left hand, no. Curves. And he'll bank it in.
Well, that was a good job by Notre Dame attacking the offensive glass. You got to get a score so you can set up your pressure. But as good a job by Washington State and not fouling.
Ball knocked away, picked up by Lowe. Under 2 minutes to go, 58-39. Lowe, 18 points, 2 rebounds, 2 assists on 6 of 15 shooting. Now he'll drive, the baseline kick to Rochesti. ...61-39, timeout Notre Dame. So the bracket, we will advance Washington State. They await the winner of North Carolina and Arkansas. They'll meet them in Charlotte next week.
And let me tell you this, Arkansas, a very up-tempo team. Good athletes, the ability to fly up and down the floor, and you know what North Carolina brings to the table. Scoring over 100 points in their game the other night. This Washington State team, they may have their hands full, but they were every bit up to the task of controlling tempo. Just calm and collected under pressure. They run their stuff, no question about it, and the defense was outstanding.
The defense is what really paced this Washington State team. Notre Dame is 13 of 53 from the field, 24.5% shooting. That may be an all-time low during the Mike Gray era. And now the subs will get an opportunity to come in. Notre Dame in Mike Gray's tenure, during Mike Gray's tenure, their lowest points, point total, rather, 48. Their lowest field goal percentage, 30%. Right now, they're at 24.5 with 39 points as both teams will clear the bench.
Well, I will say this, though, having covered Notre Dame throughout this year, they are a quality basketball team. They're a team that can put points on the board. They're a team that defends pretty well. But they more than met their match today. Notre Dame not on their game. A lot of that had to do with Washington State's outstanding defense. But take nothing away from Notre Dame's season. More wins in the Big East Conference than Notre Dame's had since joining that conference with 14. 25 wins on the season. And they just had an outstanding year. They just ran into a team that just plays the heck out of defense.
Able to dictate the pace from the very beginning. Inside Peoples, and he is fouled with 25.5 to go. 61-39, our score. Great learning experience for that young man. We talked about how tough he is and how hard of a worker he is. However, there are some things that he has to work on, especially learning how to adjust when that double team comes.
Yeah, and we saw it time and again when he was doubled, he'd rather force the issue than stepping back and turning and facing the defense, making a pass that's going to get to the open man, usually on the other side of the floor, and then following the pass so he can get a one-on-one situation in the paint.
Can't question his heart, though. 22 boards.
No question. I mean, the guy is definitely a young man that comes to play every night. I call him the bull in the china shop affectionately because I like the way he goes after it. But he's just a sophomore. Big East player of the year is a sophomore. He's got more to learn. Who can tell how great his potential is?
So how about this? Washington State, 61-41 winners over Notre Dame. The Cougars improved to 26-8, and they will head to Charlotte, where they will take on the winner of North Carolina and Arkansas.